it's Jessie V, and today I'm in lilac. I don't think I've ever owned this color in my closet ever. And the other day I was shopping with my sister and I saw this color and it was $5. This shirt was $5, so I was like, how could I not get it? So now I own lilac. Lilac is this color, right? This looks like a lilac. I don't really know though. Anyways, today's video, it's been something I've been going through for about 10 years of my life now, but I've only recently been diagnosed with it. And you're probably like, Jessie, what are you talking about? So I'm just gonna start from the very beginning. And the reason why I do these videos on like health and issues that people go through is because these are very common problems. So anybody watching this who is going through the same thing as me, maybe they won't feel as alone. And for people who maybe have the same symptoms as me that haven't gone to the doctor about it, maybe this is a good video to inform you. And if you're just someone who likes listening to my content and you haven't gone through this, that's okay too. It's still good to learn things and to listen and to just be like involved in the V team, you know what I mean? I hate making videos that are really dark and sad and emotional, so I'm gonna try and keep this as positive. It's not really positive, but this is not gonna be one of those videos where I start crying because I'm just not, I can't do that today. And trust me, this whole issue that I'm about to talk about has been something I've cried about for many nights. Whenever I'm having a really bad day with my heart, I cry and cry, so I feel like I've gotten all my cries out and now I can just sit here and talk to you guys like a normal human being. Hopefully. I mean, how many videos have I put on this channel that I've been crying? Probably a handful, I would say. I would say no less than 5. Maybe like 8, I don't know. But it's not like a bad thing to show that part of yourself, right? I mean, everybody cries, everyone has their bad days, it's fine. Anyways, you guys are probably very confused as to what I'm talking to right now, so I'm just gonna get into it from the very start. So when I was about maybe 12 years old, let's say, could have been 11, could have been 12, I started noticing something very weird about my heart. And it was usually around bedtime for some reason, like the whole entire day I would be fine, and then when I went into bed and when I'd lie down and I'd try and sleep, I would have this feeling in my chest, and the best way to describe it is I would have these normal heartbeats and one would suddenly be really, really hard. Like I'd have a really hard heartbeat and they would go back to normal. And when I was that young, it wouldn't happen that often. Like maybe it would happen like twice a month, never anything serious that I was really worried about it. It just felt like my heart was beating and suddenly one of my heartbeats just wanted to kind of like jump out of my chest. It was like like that. That's the best way to describe it. And in my head, I was like, okay, maybe everyone's heart beats like this. I don't know. Like, I just didn't really concentrate on it that much. And I remember one day I brought it up to my mom in a casual conversation, and she was like, oh, don't worry. Like, I have that same thing too. It's called heart palpitations. And my mom really reassured me because she was like, all my life, I've had that as well since I was a kid. I get it a couple times a month. And it's basically just where sometimes one of your heartbeats is irregular. But it's not a concern as long as it's not very often, you know what I mean? And I know a lot of people get heart palpitations. It's not like an uncommon thing. Like you watching this right now, you've probably noticed a couple times in your life where your heartbeat, like suddenly one beat was bigger than the other ones. And I'm not explaining heart palpitations medically correct. I'm trying to explain it in a way that you guys would understand, you know what I mean? But I remember my mom took me to the doctor about it anyways, just to make sure that everything was okay. And I went there and he listened to my heart and he was like, don't worry, you're gonna be fine. As long as your heart palpitations stay very far apart and you only get them every so often, you're good. So that's what everybody was telling me and I was like, cool, like I'm gonna be fine. I was a very anxious person though as a kid, so as much as I knew I would be okay, I did have anxiety about it sometimes. So as time went on, like through high school and everything, I was having these heart palpitations like, I don't know, 3 or 4 times a month. It was nothing crazy. I was kind of growing up and living my life, and yeah, that was always in the back of my mind because it was happening not only at night anymore, like it would happen just randomly throughout the day, and I would find that stress would bring it on a lot more. And what was really strange was whenever I went to like a doctor or something just for a different issue, usually doctors listen to your heart, right? And whenever they would listen to my heart, the doctor would be like, are you like panicking right now? Why is your heartbeat so like fast? And I'd be like, no, I feel totally fine, like I'm really calm right now. And the doctors would always be like, your heartbeat is like extremely fast. Like, take a breath, calm down. And I'd be like, I am calm. Like, literally, this is just my resting heart rate. So I found that was like a trend because I probably went to the doctors like once or twice a year in high school. And every time I went and they'd listen to my heart, they'd be like, this is way too fast. But then they would check my blood pressure. My blood pressure was fine. It was just the speed of my heart that they were always concerned about. But they never sent me for tests or did anything to sort of follow up with that. They'd always just be like, you're probably just anxious, calm down. Like, it was always just an anxiety thing to them instead of an actual heart function issue. So for about 10, 11 years, I was getting heart palpitations a couple times a month, as I've been saying. And it wasn't until this past summer that they really started to ramp up. Is that the word, ramp up? Amp up? So I would say in July, I went from having heart palpitations 2-3 times a month to 2-3 times a week, which was very odd, but I was so used to having them my whole life that I wasn't like terrified or anything. But I remember telling my mom like, hey, I'm having these more frequently, is that okay? And she would say, yeah, I mean, as long as it's not every single day, you're probably fine. So then in August, I started having them every single day. It wasn't all day, it would be like maybe once or twice a day, but that was still 7 days a week, once or twice a day. So it was speeding up and I was like, that is so weird. I don't know why that's happening. Maybe I'm just really stressed. But I sort of just didn't go to a doctor about it because I've had them all my life. Then September came around and I was having them maybe 5 times a day. So like every couple hours. And then by October, I was having them every half an hour. So it was like my heart for the entire day was not getting into a normal rhythm. It was like every few minutes, I would have this like moment where my heart would stutter. That's probably the best way I can describe it. It would just be beating normally and suddenly it'd be like do-do-do-do-do. Like it almost felt like I was having a heart attack. There was never any pain involved, but I would suddenly feel like you're not supposed to feel your heartbeat. Like when you're sitting normally, you don't feel your heart inside your chest unless you put your hand over it, right? But it would be like I would be sitting there and suddenly when I'd have that spasm in my heart, I would feel it in my chest and it was terrifying. And whenever it would happen, this jolt of shock would go through me because you kind of go into survival mode because you're like, what is my body doing? Am I dying? Am I having a heart attack? Like, what's going on? So I'd always like grab my heart and like freak out until it was done. And when I was younger, it would happen for like 3 seconds. And this past October, it would happen for like, I don't know, 7-10 seconds. And that's 10 seconds is a long time to wait for your heart to stop spasming. It's really scary. So finally in October, I went to see a doctor and they sent me to get an echocardiogram. And it's basically when they put like all these wires all over your chest and they listen to your heartbeat and there's like this chart thing that shows like a little line of your heart beating. You know, if you watch movies and people are in the hospital and you can see that like heart monitor beside them that's moving, that's basically what an echocardiogram is. So they could see in that my heart would be doing this and suddenly it would be like ch-ch-ch. Like that, all of a sudden. So the person who did that test was like, yeah, your heart is definitely irregular. You should probably have a heart monitor. So I don't know if you guys remember, but I did a couple videos back in October, November, where I was wearing a heart monitor. And those things are so annoying because there's these little sticky wires all over you. And I have really sensitive skin. So wherever one of the wires was with the sticker on it, I would have this huge rash on my skin. It was terrible. And I had to wear one of them for, I think, 14 days. So like whenever you go to shower, you have to take the wires off and then put them back on yourself. And it's just like, it's interesting. And there's this button on the monitor that when you're having like a heart palpitation issue, you press the button and it records that whole session. So when I was finally done with the heart monitor, I went back to see my cardiologist and he was like, yeah, you definitely have a lot of heart palpitations during the day. Like he says, this is a bit abnormal because people don't usually have that much unless they have like a heart arrhythmia, like a really bad problem. And he also told me that I have a very, very fast heartbeat. So I was diagnosed with a disorder called tachycardia. I hope I'm saying that right, but it's where your heart beats abnormally fast because I know normally people's heart rates are like 60 beats per minute. I think that's like the average. I'm just gonna check. So athletes might have a normal resting heart rate at 40 beats per minute, but generally the average heart rate is like 60. It's obviously gonna vary depending on like your height, your age, your weight, all kinds of stuff like that, how much you work out, blah, blah, blah. But my resting heart rate is around 95 to 100 beats per minute, which is insane. And then when I work out, I'm almost at 200 beats per minute, which is like heart attack rate. But like my body's so used to it. So I was diagnosed with tachycardia and also severe arrhythmia. So my heart's never really beating normally. And I know a lot of people go through that. So I'm not sitting here like, wow, I have a rare disorder. Like, no, this is pretty common. A lot of you guys watching this might have the same thing. And there are some things that I can do for myself that make the arrhythmia less often. Like for example, the last few months I've been taking a lot of zinc. It's a zinc supplement and I've been taking it because it's like an immune system booster because I get sick really easy. So zinc tablets sort of fight off colds really easily. But I didn't know that taking a lot of zinc actually makes your heart arrhythmia even worse. So the past 3 months of me taking zinc, my palpitations were so bad. Like every few seconds I'd have one. So it was like all day long, my heart was just spasming all over the place and I was like, I'm gonna die like this. So then I saw a doctor and they were like, try to stop taking zinc and see if that will help. So I stopped and it actually really helped. Like now I'm only having them like, I don't know, 5-6 times a day, which is way better than every minute, right? So there's certain things that you can do. Like I know a lot of supplements can make it worse. So kind of try and figure out what works and what doesn't for you. I know stress makes it worse. So you have to try and find things that calm yourself down, whether that's reading, art, watching movies, doing something that occupies your mind so you're not really focusing on what your heart's doing. I know yoga really helps, going to get massages monthly really helps. Really all you have to do is go on Google and there's a lot of people giving advice on how to sort of soothe these heart palpitations. I just don't want this video to scare you. Like if you've had symptoms like I have, it's not a death sentence. Honestly, it's so common, but definitely don't just take my advice because I'm not a doctor. So if you're having issues, definitely go see a cardiologist, go see your family doctor and get it checked out because you want to make sure it's not a more serious issue. If it happens to just be that you have arrhythmia or tachycardia, it's something you can get through. So yeah, I just want to put it out there that if anyone is watching this who has the same thing, don't worry, I have it too. A lot of people do and we just get through life. There are people who live to be 90 years old who have had arrhythmia their whole entire life and they're fine. It's all about how you deal with it and how you handle your stress and anxiety with it. And yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave it open to the comment section down below. Definitely comment some advice if you've been through this. It's great to sort of start a community down there, a family, and just talk to each other and help each other. And that's why I make videos like this, to help people not feel so alone and to give people a topic to discuss with each other to help, you know what I mean? So yeah, that is my story with my heart disorder. It could be a lot worse, I know that. I feel really blessed because it's not a serious issue, but it's something I have to watch. But yeah, I just have the best health, don't I? Anyways, guys, I hope you have an awesome rest of your day. I just want to let you know that I'm starting a few new series on my channel and I'm really excited for them and I hope you guys enjoy them. They're coming out really soon. I just kind of want to revamp this channel, you know what I mean? And also, before I go, don't forget to go subscribe to VVlogs. The link is down below in the description. I am vlogging there every single day, well, 5 times a week. So if you want to see more of my life, definitely head over there. And yeah, I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day and I will see you in my next video. Bye!